श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः Bhagwan Ram had asked questions because there are two types of associations. One leads to bondage, other leads to liberation. And how can we cure that wrong bondage which leads to association which leads to bondage? This was the question. In reply to this, it was told by Vasishtha ji, Dehe dehe vibhagaika parityagena bhavana deha matretu vishwasa sango bandhara uchate atmaiva kalvidam sarvam kim grunami tejami kim iti asanga samstiti viddi jivan muktatvamuttitam. Deha dehe vibhagaika parityagena. We have to recognize these two things distinctly. One is the container and second is the content. Dehi, deha, the body. Dehi, the embodied. And for this we don't require any extraordinary intelligence. See, the mouth is an instrument. Behind the mouth, there is somebody who is talking. Like mic is an instrument. Behind the mic, there is somebody who is talking. The mic itself cannot talk. Similarly, the mouth itself cannot talk. The eyes themselves are not seeing. There is somebody behind the eyes. Like my glasses cannot see. There are eyes behind the glasses. Otherwise, what I can do for invigilation in the examination, I'll keep my glasses on the table and go for a walk. No. Behind the eyes, the glasses, the eyes are needed. Behind the eyes, there is somebody. So this vibhaga, this clear understanding, when this is not properly understood, then what we take? We take ourselves to be the body. And this mistaking, deha matre tu vishwasaha bhavana. Bhavana means we are just imagining that this is my direct experience. See? By this bhavana, one leads to vishwasaha sango bandhara uchate. So our whole life is lived only on this foundation. I am body, I am body, I am body. And see the funny part of it. Nobody says I am body. But everybody is living as the body. Like in Hindi, the gender comes in the verbs. If I had to say in Hindi, I being a man, I will not say, Mai ja rahi hoon. I will say, Mai ja raha hoon. Because the gender is associated with the verb. Ja rahi is a feminine. Ja raha is a masculine. See, the Gujaratis in Bombay, they talk this type of language. Because in their house, they have got the Maharashtrian ladies working. So, those ladies, they talk the feminine language. So, they will say, me yete, that means I'll come. Now the Gujarati doesn't know the difference. So he also tells me, Swamiji, tumi kadi yete? Are Ram Ram, kadi yete, I am a man. I am not a woman. So we know one of us ever say, I am body, but we are all living only as the body. And therefore, happy birthday to you. Who is born? Our whole life is conducted only on this foundation. After I accept myself to be body, then I am husband, I am wife, I am mother, I am father, I am son, I am daughter. See? This is the basic error. And because of this, we are all suffering in life. See, friends. Therefore, deha dehi vibhagaika parityagena bhavana deha matre tu vishwasaha sangha bandhara uchate. Then atmaiva khalvidam sarvam kim grunami tyajami kim iti asanga sthiti viddhi jivan muktitva uttitam. And the second option, I alone am everything. This we don't have to do anything. Only come to recognize. See, there are two types of knowledges. One type of knowledge demands follow-up action. See, you start your car and start your GPS and see the destination and then stop there. No, you have to walk. Similarly, we are told, if you do Gayatri Purasharan 2400,000 times, standing on the legs in the cold waters of Ganges, dip up to the chest, then taking the hand up, and then start doing Om Bhurvasvaha Tassaviturvarenyam 2400,000 times. Then what will happen? You will get Brahma Tej. Oh, I have heard about it. Then, now you do it. Oh, I will do it also, yes. So, one knowledge is that knowledge which demands follow-up action. Now the second knowledge, which doesn't demand any follow-up action. The cloth behind me is green. This knowledge. Now what do you have to do? Nothing. It is green. Over. Exactly the same way. See? If I is not there, the world cannot exist. The whole world is in me. If I am not there, my wife cannot be. If I am not there, my children cannot be. If I am not there, my country cannot be. If I am not there, my God cannot be. If I am not there, there is nothing. Therefore, this I alone extends as everything. Expansion of I is the world. Contraction of the world is I. Therefore, Atmaiva Kalvidam Sarvam Kim Grunnami Tejami Kim. Then what should I collect and what should I give up? See? That which is recognized as I, we can neither reject nor gain. Aheyam Anupadeyam. Which cannot be given up, Aheyam, and therefore it cannot be gained because you are already that. Therefore, in the spiritual evolution is only a process of giving up. And we come to a point where the giving up ends, and that point is our essential nature. After that, there is neither desire nor anything. This is what Jivan Muktitva Muttitam. From here, the Jivan Mukti begins. Nabhinandati naishkarmyam na karmasu anuruddhyate susamoya phalatyagi so asam sakti iti smritaha. Now such a person who has come to this experience of being everything. See, we don't have desire about our hands. We don't have desire about our stomach. We don't have desire about our head if we have. Because it is already me. we cannot desire ourselves. There are two conditions under which desires can be removed. Number one, something is recognized as an illusion. We do not desire illusions. Second condition, when there is no sense of otherness, there cannot be any desire. Desire is only when there is a sense of otherness. Therefore, such a person, na abhinandati naishkarmyam, he is not very happy when he doesn't have to do anything, and na karmasu anuruddhate, nor he gets caught up in all kinds of activities in the world. Susamoya phalatyagi, he is equanimous under all conditions. Whether one has to get into work and work hard, or one has to withdraw, in both the conditions. Susamaha, equanimous. See, friends, one of the biggest difficulty in one's life is laziness. Spiritual life doesn't mean TK is okay, this is enough. No, no, no. Work hard. Achieve success. And then give up. I'll tell you about this, how important it is. It happened somewhere in Badrinath many years before, and some satsang was going on. I was also there. So that Mahatmaji told every Mahatma to talk something. About 5-6 of us were sitting on the dais. And he said, your mother tongue? Telugu. You talk in Telugu. What is your mother tongue? Tamil. You talk in Tamil. Like that, Gujarati, Tamil, Marathi, and Kannadiga, Hindi, Punjabi. When he came to me, I was sitting at the end so that I can go away quickly. So he asked me, you talk in English. He didn't ask me my mother tongue. You talk in English. So I had no choice. Then I spoke, and I knew nobody understands there. But even then, I had to talk. So I spoke for 5 minutes. After that, when we were going, I did namaskar to him and going. Very elderly Mahatma. That time I was pretty young. And all the jata and everything, you know. So he asked me, you wait, you don't go. So I sat on the floor. No, don't sit here. Come, sit next to me. So all right. And what I heard from him, that day I had discovered one biggest principle in life. What he could say? He said, I wish I had studied English. I would have gone round the world spreading the message of Gita. But during our time, learning English was considered as bad. Today I am regretting. What is the use of all your things? See, work hard, earn money, be affluent. See, living in daridrya, poverty, is not spirituality. See, friends, and after having done that, then give it up. Otherwise, something will be like that Mahatma. After having lived in a place like Badrinath for so many years, what was in his mind? I wish I had studied English. You know what is dispassion? Dispassion is demonstrated in India in a practical way. We take the piece of sugar cane, put it in our mouth and chew it. And all the juice is swallowed. And there, after being a real, true Indian, wherever we are standing, and go ahead. We are not worried. No. Like here, everything they will collect in their mouth, even the dog shit. They collect. Dirty. therefore never put hand in anybody's purse, particularly ladies, morning time when they go, you put hand and you don't know what will come. Purnamadaha purnamidam purnam. In the same manner, earn a lot and just discard it. Simple living, high thinking, we mistake as the shabby living and stupid thinking. No. That is not spiritual life. So, nabhinandati naishkarmyam na karmasu anushruddhate susamohi phalatyagi and loka asamsakta iti smritaha. And he is no more involved, attached to anything in this world. Asangena sarvascha cheshta nana vijrumbita chikitsita bhavanteva shreya sampadayati cha. So, asamsangena sarvascha cheshta nana vijrumbita api. So, a person who is not attached to anything in this world and yet dynamically involved in this world, not leading a lazy life. Hey friends, one day one boy asked me this question. He said, Swamiji, please tell me, you know I am a brahmachari, now I have to work. Can you give me one instruction which I will try to follow in my whole life? I said, okay, listen. That day when you have not attended satsang, that day when you have not conducted satsang, that day when you have not studied swadhyaya, that day you are not qualified to take food. See? As food is for life, satsanga is for sadhana. Otherwise, for us, laziness, you know. And at the most, eat and sleep. Such people become pigs next life. So, asangena sarvascha cheshta nana vijrumbita, then vichikitseta bhavanti eva. Then the disease of attachment will be cured. See, work hard, achieve, and give up. That is what is called a spiritual life. Bhutani yat anantani tarangini tarangavat utpadyotpadyate liyante tat samsakti vijrumbitam. All these things are coming and going like the waves on the ocean. They are only born out of samsakti because of attachment. We keep on collecting the thing, giving up the things, collecting the thing, giving up the things. And many of us don't know the importance of giving up. Keep on collecting, collecting. When you go back to your house, you enter your walk-in wardrobe. You will have to fix a GPS how to come out. You are so much lost in that. See? He keeps coming out. There is no end to it. Learn this art of emptying first your houses. Collecting the things, accumulating the things in the outer world doesn't remain there. It goes inside. And how it goes inside? By way of collecting memories. Wherever you go, take a selfie, take it, and then after delete it. You don't have to keep it. There was a mother, she called her son. My dear son, see what happened to your wife. She is behaving very weird way, twisting her face and falling down and all kinds of things. I don't know what happened to her. Please come quickly. He said, Mama, don't worry. She must be taking selfies. And what will you do with that? See, I am a victim of this. When we go to somebody's house and if there was marriage and I have not attended that marriage, then it is the calamity for me. Swamiji, you did not come. Therefore, for you specially, we have prepared this album. Like Al-Qaeda, album. And then, okay, then I'll check it, I'll see it, okay? You prepare the breakfast. No, no, I'll explain you. Now tell me, what is there to explain in album? Is it a Bhagavad Gita? It is Upanishad, it is Yoga Vasishtha. And then they will not leave. Then I open the Vasha. Who is this lady? Looks like a kabutar, you know, Dumbo. Who is this lady? Swamiji, she is me. Oh, very beautiful. Therefore, yesterday I told you, one of the spiritual practices, before you talk to anybody, ask a question, is it necessary to talk? You will come to a very clear understanding. Whenever we talk to others, we talk only about our past. The burden of the past creates the miserable personality of somebody. This is what is ego. Ego is nothing but a mule carrying the burden of total past possessions and relations. You just try to talk without reference to any possession and any relation. Now try to talk. Nothing to talk. See, my friends, therefore, bhutani yad anantani tarangini tarangavat utpadya liyante tat samsakti samvijrumbitam. Because of this, we are again born and again dying. One small example I'll tell you. There was one child born in a family. In India it happened. And that boy was extremely attached to his grandmother. Right from day one. He will not go even to his own mother. He wants only grandmother. So the grandmother has to feed him, grandmother has to give him bath, and she was also happy to do for the grandson. Now, few months, then 1 year over, 2 years over, 3 years over, that grandchild is not ready to leave the grandmother. As he was growing, 5 years, 6 years, he started dictating his grandmother. What clothes she should put on, to whom she should talk or not, what she should eat or not, what she should give him. And it became so miserable for that grandmother. Finally, they went to some Panditji and saw the thing, chart, and some puja to be done. And the Panditji told very clearly, whether you like or you don't like, this jiva in this boy is your departed husband. Because he must have been extremely attached to that lady. Marne ke baad bhi nahi chodenge. I won't leave you. Therefore, you are not married for one life, 7 lives. No suffer. If you are attached. See, friends, be very attentive. Yo ya shraddha sa eva saha. Whatever is your shraddha that you are, you consider yourself to be husband, you are bound to be miserable. You consider yourself to be wife, you are unfortunate. There's no way out. Consider yourself to be the body, you are going to become old and die. Consider yourself to be the jiva, you will be born again and again. It is only the story of bhavana, what you take yourself to be. And we have got a freedom for that. Accept yourself to be divine, infinite, non-dual, absolute being. You are not born again. Can there be simpler spiritual practice than this? Therefore, samsakti dvividha prokta vandhya vandhya charagava. So this attachment is of two types. One is vandhya, second is vandhya. Tamilians will not find the difference between the two. For Tamilians, ta tha da dha is same. Therefore, when the Tamilians have to say, Om Sri Gadadharaya Namaha, Lord Narayan has given instead of the Gada in the hand, Gada is given. Vandya and Vandya. Vandya means worthy of respect. Vandya means sterile. Vandya Putra. A sterile lady cannot bear children. See, Vandya. So there are two of them. Which are those? Vandya Sarvatra Mudhanam, Vandya Tattva Vidam Nija. So this unproductive attachment is for the fools. Unproductive attachment is for the wise. Both of them are wise. So who are they? Atma Tattva Bodhena Hina Dehadi Vastuja. Not recognizing one's essential nature and therefore extremely attached to the body and all the relations of the body. Bhuja eva samsara samsakti yadruda vande vandhyati kathyate. So one is attached to the body and therefore continues in the samsara. This is unproductive attachment. Keeps you in bondage. And second thing, Atma Tattvava Bodhena Satya Bhuta Vivekaja Vandya Hi Katyate Sakti Bhuya Samsara Varjita. But if we are extremely attached to our divine nature, if we are attached to somebody, we keep on talking about that body again and again, is it not? See the mothers. They have no other topic in the world. 24, bachche bachariya, enough of it. There is one girl, I know for so many years. And she has seen me when I was also young, she was also young. And I used to play with the kids and all that. Now she is married and she has children. So when her children were small, I used to sometimes say hello, good night. But every day, you are sending the pictures of the same useless children. How many times will I see those pictures? And all the time, Skype. Swamiji, my Dumbo is talking to you. Talk. What do I talk? There is no other topic. So, one day she told me, Swamiji, you have changed. I said, yes, everything changes. I have changed. No, I don't mean that. But, you know, you are not playing with my children and you are also not spending time with me. I said, there is no other topic to talk to you. Only one topic in the whole universe. My children, are enough of it, enough. See, there are many things in this world. Such people get totally lost in this samsara. So, what is the Atma Tattvava Bodhena Satya Bhuta Vivekaja Samsakti? When we are with the children, yes, do your job, but don't carry 24/7 the same thing. We have something higher to achieve in life. Now, this is Vandya Hi Katyate Sakti. This is Vandaniya, this is worthy of following. Therefore, whatever we have to do, do that and be aware of your purpose in life. The only thing which is possible and necessary after having born as a human being is to evolve spiritually. All other things are okay in their own place. One day one of my friends told me, Swamiji, we have decided that we will propose, because we know so many ministers and so many people, propose your name for getting the national honor. Humne kaha khabardar. Why? I said, look here. The first Bharat Ratna was given to one Dr. Matre. He was the one who was responsible for establishing ONGC in India. Very intelligent, dedicated person. He was given the first Bharat Ratna. I happened to go to his house. He was no more there. His wife was there, very old, 98 not out. And in that house, everything was in dilapidated condition. And when I was seeing the wall, it was all leaking waters here and there. And then there I saw this certificate, Bharat Ratna. All water seeping in that. And I said, Rama has come and gone. Where is your Ayodhya? Krishna has come and gone. Where is your Dwarka? Bharat Ratna. Where are we? Is this spirituality? See, friends, these are all the tricks that God is playing with us. Therefore, Atma Tattvava Bodhena Satya Bhuta Vivekaja Vandyahi Kattate Sakti Bhuya Samsara Varjita. Then you are no more again entangled in this world. Therefore, Brahmadya Lokapalascha Vandya Sansakti Yuta Smrita. All the great powers in this world, like the Brahmaji, etc., and all the gods protecting the world, they are in this way, abiding in the self and practicing in the life. Live as divine and let divinity express through every action, every word, every thought. So wherever we are put by the Lord, that is done perfectly well. But at the same time, the ability to withdraw instantaneously. See? Once in US, I was driving very rarely and I jumped the red light. So the police stopped and he said, gave the license. He said, you have the license? Driving license, yes. Then why didn't you stop when there was a red light? Morning time. So I said, officer, actually, you know, I have only driving license. I don't have stopping license. So when I said like that, he laughed. He said, man, you made my day. Okay, don't do it again, okay? Now when driving license is given to us, doesn't it include the stopping also? In the same manner, we have freedom to get involved in this world with equal freedom to stop. But we are unable to stop. And then we get attached. One more example I'll tell you about this attachment, how it is miserably bad. This again happened somewhere. One of our NRI girls, I knew her when she was class 7, class 6. Now she is married, two children. When her second pregnancy was going on, her mother came from India to that particular country, wherever she was. And when I was also in that particular city, so she called me, Swamiji, after my office hours, I want to come and meet you. I said, come, I am in such and such place. Dinner, you come for dinner. So she came for the dinner, we finished dinner. Then she wanted to walk with me. She was carrying 8 months or 7.5 months, whatever. And then she held my hand, slowly walking and crying. I said, hey, come on, yeah, don't cry. I don't like this crying business. Tell what is the problem. Swamiji, I left in the morning the home by scolding and fighting with my mother. I told her, go back to India, I don't want you here in my house. And I went to work. The whole day in the work also I was miserable. Now I had to go home again. And she is also crying there. My father called me and telling that your mother is crying. She is not taking food. And this is the situation. Tell me, what should I do? So I kept quiet. Then she started. Since she came, to help me in my late pregnancy, only one topic: how my brother's wife is bad. Every day, morning onwards, Uttishto Uttishto Govinda Uttishto Gurudadvaja. Since morning, only one topic: how my brother's wife, that means her daughter-in-law, is bad. One day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, how many times can you listen? She said, I got so fed up. Finally, I told, should I go and kill her? See? And if you don't like, you leave my house. I don't want here. You have come to help me or you torture me. And thereafter I left. Now be very attentive. Learn the moral of the story. When the children have to speak a very bitter language to the parents, don't think children are happy. They are already hurt inside. But we, the so-called elders, don't understand this. Because we are obsessed. See, my friends, this asakti is bandha, is bondage. And therefore, sarvada sarvasamsthena sarvena sahatishtata sarva karma rate napi manak karyam vijanata na saktam iha cheshtasu na chintasu na vastushu. Therefore, vijanata, the one who has learned this principle, by him, manaha karyam, what should be the condition of the mind? Sarvada sarvasamsthena sarvena sahatishtata. All the time living with everybody, under all undertakings, sarva karma ratenapi, although extremely involved in this world, yet na saktam, one should not be attached to cheshtasu, the activities, chintasu, the themes, and vastushu, the object. Live dynamically in this world, but reserve your freedom to withdraw instantaneously. See, friends, one day one Mahatma asked this question, Swamiji, how come you start and stop perfectly, don't drag beyond time? I said, because before the people have to throw stones at me, I should get out quickly. Before somebody has to tell, Mahatmaji, how much do you charge to keep your mouth shut? See, both things are important. Ability to get involved and ability to withdraw. And this is possible only if we are not attached to anything. See, many people are under disguise of this social service. What is their social service? I am a teetotaler. If I had to take social service, what I will think about? Nobody should drink. If I am vegetarian, what will be my social service? I want the whole world to be vegetarian. Work only on that. If I am a student of Gita, what will be my social service? Everybody should study Gita. Think, our social service is nothing but imposition of our views on others. By that, we become more and more attached. See, therefore, one has to remain extremely alert that we are dynamically involved in this world, but none of the worldly things are able to tie us down. Then, kevalam chiti vishramya, kinchit chityavalambapi, sarvatra nirasamiva, tishtatu atmarasammana. Therefore, although casually getting involved in the world as need of the time, and yet manaha atmarasam, the mind is bathing in the bliss of one's being, not seeking happiness outside, The search for happiness is the most miserable search. Don't seek, discover. When we discover something, it is already existing. But it was covered by something. Like many times it happens. We have the key in our own hand and we are searching, where is the key, where is the key? And then we get it, oh, I found it. Did you ever lose it? You have discovered. We have to discover the bliss that we are. And we are not able to discover the bliss because we are covered by blisters. And blisters come because of wrong rubbing. If you don't put on the shoes, you will never get blisters. But when you put on the shoes, then your skin and the shoes, wall, they keep on rubbing each other and the blister comes. Dvitiyatvai blisteram bhavati. See? Therefore, here kevalam chiti vishramya, remain ever poised in the conscious being, and then manaha tishtatu atmarasam, let the mind be enjoying the bliss of being. Tatrasto vigata sango jivo ajivatva magataha vivaharam imam sarvam na karotu karotu va. And as we start living more and more in our divine self, the conscious blissful existence, then jivaha ajivatva magataha, be attentive. Then the jiva becomes non-jiva. Now what is the meaning of this? See, friends, basically, it is life. Life is common everywhere. And life becomes functional through the agency of mind. Be attentive. That mind has two aspects. One aspect is common mind for all of us. Like we have got common five elements. We have got common. It's not that my space is Indian space and your space is Australian space. No, common space. In the same manner, we all have common mind. And because of that common mind, life is functioning. Now, the second aspect of the mind is, the mind takes the shape of a particular body. That creates a specific mind. Like gold is common for all ornaments, but the name and the form of a particular ornament creates a specific individuality. Now what happens? When we sleep, that time what happens? Our mind gives up the shape of that particular body and returns back to the common status. So when we are identified with the body, I am somebody, somebody is a jiva, the soul. When in deep sleep, the mind drops the shape and size and identification with the body, but the mind still is functioning because of which the life is. That time the jiva has become non-jiva. The jiva is vyakti individuality. Life is abhivyakti non-individuality. See, my friends, therefore, tatrastha vigata sangaha. So when you are thus living more and more in this conscious being, vigata sangaha, no more getting involved too much in this world, in due time, you will lose your individuality and merge in the totality. Like the waters are totality and the ice is individuality. Ice does not sustain life. The icebergs in the oceans, they don't sustain life. It is the waters which sustain the life. That is why very clearly we told you, spiritual evolution is not becoming someone extraordinary. Drop that extra. You are not someone special. But there also, as if we are carrying less burden of speciality. I am man, I am woman, I am young, I am old, I am married, I am not married, I am rich, I am poor, I am educated, I am uneducated, I am overeducated. In addition to that, I am spiritual, or a dumbo. What spiritual? Discard all special status. Life is common. The happiness that a rich man gets by eating the choice food, the same quality of happiness a pig gets when he eats his food. Satiation of hunger is a common experience for life. See, my friends, therefore, by this asam sakti, tatrastha vigata sangaha, jiva ajitvam ajivatvam agataha, vivaharam imam sarvam na karotu karotu va. And therefore, in that stage, you are not obliged to follow any law of karma. See? Because you are no more an individual. You are no more driving the car. The passengers don't get the tickets. See? Like a football player, what can he dream? A football player's dream will be, I get a penalty corner. And in that dream, his son was sleeping next to him. And in that dream, this fellow gave a kick and the son is out of the bed. Will he be punished for that? Because he is not there. See? One wife took her husband to the doctor and told, Doctor Saab, my husband keeps on talking whole night. I don't know what to do. Please give him some medicine. So the doctor said, okay, sit down. He took out from his drawer some medicine and told her, now you take this medicine. No. I'm okay. I'm telling about him. That is what I'm telling you. You take this medicine. Why? When you will take this medicine, the whole day you will keep quiet. Then he can talk. When he will talk during the day, he doesn't have to talk at night. How simple it is. Constantly, somebody is there. Get rid of that somebody. See? Upanishad very clearly tells, in deep sleep, tatra mata amata bhavati. Tatra pita apita bhavati. In deep sleep, we are neither mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife. Therefore, that husband who dares not open his eyes in front of the wife, how can he snore so loudly? Because he is no more husband. He is a human being. See? Therefore, अथवा तमपि त्यक्त्वा चित्त्यांशं शान्तचित्गणः जीवतिष्ठतु संशान्तः ज्वलन् मणिरिवात्मनि. Or let this seeker only hold on to the conscious principle and remain there as शान्तचित्गणः, absolute conscious blissful existence, abiding in the absolute, dissolved back, no more personality. No more blessing. No more cursing. Blessing and cursing demands sense of otherness. See? See friends, e vaisharama saushupti sthiti abhyasa yogatah pravunasati turi yeti kathita tattva kovidai. So he ram esha pravuna saushupti sthiti abhyasa yogatah, when you this practice again and again. So what we have to practice? Number one, don't get involved too much in this world. Number two, start emptying your houses and start emptying your past. Don't talk to others unless required. Stop talking to yourself. Slowly withdraw from the world, not out of depression, but out of wisdom. And remain silent, alone, without feeling lonely. So you are neither awake nor sleeping. You are not awake because the world is no more disturbing you. You are not sleeping because you are experiencing the world. Bhagavad Gita, second chapter. Yanisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagarti sayami yasyam jagrati bhutani sanisha pashyato mune. Where the ignorant people are awakened to this relative world, to that this awakened Mahatma is sleeping to the relativity, and to that absolute reality to which the wise man is awakened, to that absolute reality the ignorant people are sleeping. Where is God? God asking the question, where is God? See my friends, therefore jiva tishtati sabshantaha esha rama saushuptiti abhyasa yogataha. And this has to be our practice. So what should be, you know, your spiritual practice? Starts with little beginning. Don't suddenly say, I want to sit for meditation for 2 hours. Never do that. Start with little, 1 minute. And in that 1 minute, do nothing. Just sit. No asana, no pranayam, no chanting, no nothing. Then your mind will suggest, simply wasting time. Why not we did write Ram, 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 Ram. The moment activities cease, mind dissolves. And who wants to die? Nobody wants to die. The mind also doesn't want to die. Therefore, mind will bring either the future or the past and survive again. So after we become perfect, we can waste 1 minute of our life effectively without doing anything, without achieving anything. That is the achievement. Then increase the quota. Make it 2 minutes. Now during these last 2 minutes, do you have any complaints? Oh, mind was running here and there. No complaint. Because you are not doing anything. It was a process of undoing. Don't do meditation. Don't do meditation. Try this. remain as nobody. 1 minute, then 2 minutes. Slowly increase your stamina. But normally what happens, okay, I'm going to sit for meditation. 1 hour I sit. Don't plan anything what you will do after meditation. If you plan, oh, Swamiji is coming for breakfast, I don't know what whether he takes onion or not. But anyway, I'll cut it and keep it ready. In the meditation is cutting onion. This is the last moment of our life. There is no past, there is no future. This is the meaning of Abhyasa Yogataha. Ev Shaiva Rama Saushupti Stiti Abhyasa Yogataha Praudhasati. When this practice becomes mature enough, then Turiya Iti Katita Tattva Kovidaihi. This is called a Turiya Stiti. Turiya means what? Normally, if you take the grammar or Sanskrit literature or dictionary, Turiya means fourth. But actually in Vedanta, Turiya doesn't mean fourth. See? Because we talk about waking, number one, dream, two, deep sleep, three, Atma, fourth. As if this absolute self is not in the three, is separate. Like waking is not in the dream, dream and waking, they are not in the deep sleep, they are mutually exclusive. In the same manner, is Atma mutually exclusive with the three? No. Then why call it fourth? In Vedanta, Turiya means the one. And not the one which is followed by two. The one which is neither followed by two nor divided by two. The absolute one. See, friends. And with this understanding, when one continues, yastu tasyam avasthayam sthiti prapya avinashinim ananda ekanta shilatvad ananda padadgataha ananda mahananda kalatita tatopisaha mukta ityuchati yogi turyatita padam tataha gataha. Now see the next step. When one thus starts living as the absolute, although functioning in the relative world, slowly, slowly, it becomes further mature and he comes to discover. His discovery is like what? Be attentive. Waves, big waves, ocean and water. Waves, waking, big waves, dream. Ocean, deep sleep, water, Turiya, the fourth. This is for whom? This is for those who have given importance to the waking, dream and deep sleep. For them, it is fourth. But if you go and ask the water, Mr. Water, excuse me, as an ocean, you are a terrible man, I am afraid. And as the waves, I enjoy. What the water will say, excuse me, gentlemen, what is ocean? And what is a wave? Water can never understand what is ocean, what is wave. Because from the absolute standpoint, relative has no existence. Therefore, Turiyatita means the ultimate state where the relativity is no more accepted, only the absolute. And this is what is called as Aham Brahmasmi or Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. In this Turiyatita state, both the things meet together. First is sarvam kalvidam brahma, and second thing is the world is an illusion. So from the water's point of view, the ocean, the big waves and small waves, they are illusions. Therefore, they do not influence the water. And again, from the water's point of view, all of them are nothing but waters. Like the sugar cane never suffers from diabetes. In the same manner, waters never get drowned in the ocean, never break when the waves break, because all of them are nothing but water. This ultimate experience is called as Turiyatita Padam Gataha. Therefore, anybody who has to do something in this world, he will only use us for his purpose, because he is already occupied with something. You can see this in this world. You go and meet somebody, some Mahatma, and that Mahatma comes to know that you are a very rich man, immediately you are received with great respect, honor, and then you tell him, no, I am already booked with the other Mahatma. Acha, very good, very good. Excuse me, I have no time, I will come later. No, but I have come here for giving donation. Acha, acha, come, go. See, friends, come to discover this. Turiyatita padam gataha. दृश्यदर्शननिर्मुक्ता यानुभूति अनामया ताम अवष्टभ्य तिष्ठत्वं सौषुप्तिं ताम मजस्थितिं. देयरफॉर हे वशिष्ठजी टेल्स, हे राम, देयरफॉर दृश्यदर्शननिर्मुक्ता या अनुभूति अनामया, दैट प्योर एक्सपीरियंस वेयर द नोअर नोन डिविजन हैज डिसअपीयर्ड. दिस व्हाट वी टोल्ड यू. Experiencer without experiencer and experienced. The knowledge without knower and the known. The joy without enjoyer and the enjoyed. See, my friends, drishya darsha nirmukta ya anubhuti anamayaha. There is no amaya, there is no disease. The disease is this division. What is called atriputi. Knowledge divided into three is knower known knowledge. Undivided knowledge is the truth. So, ताम अवष्टभ्य तिष्ठत्वं सौषुप्तिं ताम भज स्थितिं. सो होल्ड ऑन टू दिस हे राम एंड रिमेन रूटेड इन दिस. न मोक्षो न भसपृष्ठे न पाताले न भूतले सर्वांशा संक्षय चेता क्षयो मोक्ष इति शते. मोक्ष लिबरेशन इज नॉट नवसा पृष्ठे अबव द क्लाउड्स, न पाताले इन द साउथ in America, na bhutale, nor in India. Then, sarvamsha samkshayak chetaha, when you are free from all desires. And, chetakshayaha, your chetas, your mind is dissolved. Moksha iti ishyate, this is what is called as liberation. Therefore, we have to be very clear. There is no gain in spiritual life. But where we want to go, where we get something, and then the stotras, you listen to any stotra, The same thing is said there. Putrarthi labhet putra. Wifearthi labhet wife. Wifiarthi labhet wifi. Only desire fulfillment is the only meaning for us about spirituality. It is not. One has to get rid of this disease of desire. Moksho me astriti chintantam jata cheta uttitam manaha manot mananothe manatischehi bandha samsariko drudaha. Now further step. Moksha me astu iti chinta, even the desire that let me have liberation is the birth of mind. See? Let me have liberation means what? I am in bondage. We are only imagining that I am unsuccessful, I am unfortunate. See, friends. So, mokshame astu iti chinta anta jata chet uttitam manaha. The moment even this thought passes in our mind that I want to realize, forget about realization, then enjoy. Once one, a Vedanti who has never digested the Vedanta, he went to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. And it is very difficult to keep the Vedanti's mouth shut. They keep on talking. That is the only thing they are taught. Keep talking, talking, talking. So other runs away. And then he is liberated. So he went to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. And Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi was in his own glorious state all the time. He started talking, blah, 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 blah. No end to it. And Bhagavan was like, you are listening or not listening. Bhagavan was also listening and not listening. Keep on talking. Talking may be in your mouth, but listening is in my ears. So he kept talking for an hour or two. Then the bell went for breakfast. Ten, 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 ten. Bhagavan said, let us go for breakfast. So with him also he walked. Walking with Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, feeling himself to be extraordinary, given a special status. And for Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi, it makes no difference whether it is a Vedanti or a cow. So they sat together on the floor for taking food. Again his chatterbox continued. That is why I don't talk too much. We talk so much unnecessarily. So, sat. And the upma came and peanut chutney. There also. Bhagwan, what is the daily schedule? What do you do in the ashram? Bhagwan said, we take upma, mix it with the chutney and eat. Afterwards, he talked to somebody. See, I asked that what do you do in the ashram and what kind of reply I got. We take the upma, mix with chutney and eat. Is it the thing I ask? He was told, Maharaj, you have not understood because you are a Vedanti. What he meant is, we live only in the present. That's it. Watch. When we are taking food, are we taking food? Our thinking is, Ram, 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 Ram. This is the highest spiritual practice. And this is what is mentioned here. Moksho me astu iti chinta. Even the very passing thought, I want liberation, forget about liberation, take food. See? So, mananothe manasya chaihi bandha samsariko drudaha. And the moment your mind is born, you are again bound in this world and you will continue to suffer. Atmanyaniti atite sarvasmat sarvabhuta sarvabhute thavatate ko bandha kashchava moksha nirmula vananam kuru. Therefore, atmani atite sarvasmat sarvabhute athava atite ko bandha kashchava moksha. Other than the self, there is neither bondage nor liberation. When I imagine I am bound, I am bound. When I imagine I am liberated, I am liberated. Are yaar, if you have to imagine, why don't you imagine you are happy? It's all, nothing serious. But for us, spirituality becomes such a burden. So, ko bandhascha kashchava moksha. Nirmolam mananam kuru. Who is bound and who is liberated? Be attentive. The jiva is bound. And then the jiva comes to know he is divine. Then who is liberated? Jiva is liberated or the divinity is liberated? One example I'll tell you. I think probably I told you. One Guru Maharaj got up in the morning and crying. So disciple said, Maharaj, what happened? I had a very bad dream. Anyway, you taught us dreams are illusions. No, no, no. Let me talk completely. Yes. And the dream, I had a feeling that I am a butterfly. And therefore, I am feeling very mad about it. But never mind. It was a dream, the disciples told. No, my question is whether your guru dreamt that I am a butterfly or the butterfly dreamt that I am a guru. Who is liberated? Jiva is liberated. If the jiva is liberated, was he real? If was not real, then who is liberated? Be very, very attentive. When my wife died, who is liberated? Husband is liberated? Without the wife, I can't be husband. Who is liberated? Think. Both liberation and bondage, they are only in the mind. And therefore, moksha nirmulam mananam kuru. Dissolve this mind. In Amrut Bindu Upanishad, it is said, mana eva manushyanam karanam bandha moksha yoho bandhaya vishaya saktam muktam nirvishayam smritam. Whenever the mind is extrovert objective in its pursuit, it becomes the cause of bondage. And when the mind has given up the objective pursuit and comes back and dissolves in its own source, it becomes the cause of liberation. Therefore, dvandva dosha bhayad mukta tirna samsara sagaraha prapta anuttama vishranti labdha labhya paraspadaha. Therefore, dvandva dosha bhayad muktaha. You will be free from the fear of this relative world. And tirna samsara sagaraha, such a person will be free from the relative existence and prapta anuttama vishranti. He will attain that peace which passes beyond all understanding. Labhya alabhya paraspadaha. That most impossible to attain is attained by such a master who has dissolved his mind in its source, the pure consciousness. Shariran vetiraktam nam pashtataha pravivekinaha vikartitangam apyasyavi na kishchit vikartitam. Such a person who is living beyond the limitations of the three bodies, even if his body's limbs are cut, he looks at them as others look. Nothing happens to him. Anabhuta guna svadhu api daha vikartanahi na shakyate natakartum tatva loka tathatmanaha. Whether the sweet jaggery is hot or cold, it is always sweet in the same manner. Under all conditions of relative existence, the self is always the self. See, friends, therefore, a person who is abiding in this knowledge all the time, param vyasanini nari vyagrapi graha karmani tad eva aswadayantah parasangarasayanam. Like a lady who is in secret love with somebody, although she is doing everything in her house, but she is always imagining and enjoying her company with her partner, something or the other. Evam tatve pare shuddhe dhiro vishranti magatah tadeva svadayantya bahi vivaran api. Such a wise person, dhiraha, shuddhe pare tatve vishranti magatah, he has now attained total fulfillment in his life. And thereafter, vivaran api bahar bahir, although he is dynamically involved in this world, but his abidance in the truth is never corrupted. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti 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 Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.